We are the people who confess Jesus Christ our God and the Savior and Lord. And we are the people who get out of this simple world and come into faith in Jesus Christ. We are the gathering of the believers in our Lord Jesus Christ. We are the church. And when we are the church, we desire our church can be really good church. Our church is really the church pleasing our Lord Jesus Christ. That's what we want. Every agape, we believe, really desire this. We desire Agape International Church can be really good church, really precious church, valuable church, the church that our Lord Jesus Christ is really pleased. Amen. So we wanna have some good exemplary church in the Bible that we see the church, that exemplary church in the Bible, and we wanna imitate. We wanna take after. We wanna be like those churches, good churches, exemplary churches. That's why today we take this title like Antioch Church. I believe Antioch Church can be very good exemplary church in the Bible to all churches today. Really, this church, very wonderful church, the church that our Lord Jesus Christ is really pleased. So today, let's see together. What does Antioch Church like, and why this church really good church, exemplary church? Let's see together. And if we know that this church is really good church, exemplary church, the church our Lord Jesus Christ is pleased, let's try to be like this church. Let's try to do like this church did. Let's imitate this church so that Agape International Church also can be very good church, and our church can be also really the church pleasing our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Yeah. Okay, today we open our Bible, Book of Acts 11, 19 through 30, chapter 13, 1 through 3, because these two Bible portions say about this church, Antioch Church. Today, Word of God says, now those who had been scattered by the persecution that broke out when Stephen was killed traveled as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch, spreading the word only among Jews. Some of them, however, men from Cyprus and Cyrene went to Antioch and began to speak to Greeks also, telling them the good news about the Lord Jesus. The Lord's hand was with them, and a great number of people believed and turned to the Lord. Amen. Jesus Christ, he ascended to heaven. Before Jesus ascended to heaven, Jesus Christ said to his disciples, later apostles, and the holy believers who followed Jesus Christ, say to them, you wait until you receive Holy Spirit. So, and Jesus Christ said to them, if Holy Spirit come upon you, you will have a power, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, whole Judea, Samaria, and to the end of the earth. Amen. So, after Jesus Christ ascended to heaven, according to words of God, the believers of Jesus Christ, they gathered together in Mark's attic, Mark's upper room, 120 believers, and they ardently pray for what Jesus Christ said to be fulfilled. Holy Spirit come upon them. They ardently pray. They pray for 10 days. And finally, in the day of Pentecost, according to Jesus' promise, Holy Spirit came upon them. Amen. When Holy Spirit came upon them, what happened? Happened exactly what Jesus said. They got the power, and when they get the power, you know, really many amazing things happen. Demon spirit being expelled, sick people being healed, miracle, wonder, signs were made. So many, you know, Judaism believers, many people who don't know Jesus Christ, who don't believe in Jesus Christ, they are able to know that Jesus Christ is a really God and the Savior and Lord of our life. So they are able to come to faith in Jesus Christ. Early church, there was a big revival in early church. Yeah. But where there is a work of God, there is a what? There is a Satan's disturbance. Satan never like, never won Church of God being revived continually. Satan never won God's church continually being prosperous and successful. So whatever way, enemy, Satan, demons, evil spirit try to disturb God's church from being revived, being prosperous and successful. So enemy, Satan, demons, evil spirit, they, you know, control the enemies, Judaism, religious leader, and start persecuted Jerusalem church, early church. The persecution was very severe. So, you know, James killed, and Deacon Stephan was killed. So, many believers, they are in danger of their life. They could not stay in Jerusalem anymore because persecution was very terrible, very severe. So, today, Word of God say, believers become to be scattered. They could not stay in Jerusalem anymore. So believers of Jerusalem church, they become to be scattered to other place. So here say, some believers of Jerusalem church, they scattered to, you know, Phoenicia, Cyprus, Antioch. And they, when they scattered those places, they continually spread the gospel. First time only for Jews. But some of them, from Cyprus and Cyrene, they went to Antioch. And they started spreading gospel, not only Jews, but to Gentile, Greek people. So let's just see this map. Where is Phoenicia? Where is Cyprus? Where is Cyrene? Where is Antioch? Let's see together. Okay, this is Jerusalem. Can you see? This is Jerusalem. Jerusalem there. There is a cross, right? Jerusalem. Yeah, yeah. So, first church, early church, was here, Jerusalem. But there was a persecution. So start to scatter. Where? Phoenicia. Phoenicia. Can you see? Today, Lebanon. Lebanon area. Lebanon. Yeah. And some go to Cyprus island, Cyprus here. And some go to Antioch. Antioch today, Syria, Antioch. Yeah. So those who scattered Phoenicia, Cyprus, Antioch, they continually spread gospel, but only to Jew, only to same people, Jewish people. But, you know, some believers from Cyrene. Cyrene is northern Africa, today Libya. Some believers are from here, from Africa, Cyrene. And some believers from Cyprus, they went to where? They went to Antioch here, Syria. When they went to the Antioch, they started spreading gospel to who? Gentile people, Greek, non-Jews. Amen. Okay, see this, yeah, here is Jerusalem, and Phoenicia, today Lebanon area, and Antioch, Cyprus, So believers, because of persecution, they scattered other place. And important thing is, when they are scattered, they continually spread gospel. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, beloved believers, there is a gathering church and scattering church. We are gathering church today. We gather together in God's temple. Amen?
Amen.
When we gather together, what we should do? We should worship our God in spirit and truth. We also pray. We also sharing the words of God. We study words of God. And we have a fellowship. Also, we do evangelism. Likewise, church, sometime gather together. Amen?
Amen.
When we gather together, what we should do? We should do according to words of God. Words of God say, if we church gather together, pray with one heart. And also we worship. And also we have a fellowship. We serve together. And we do evangelism. And also we, you know, studying Bible. Bible studying. Likewise, church is sometimes gathering. But below that purpose, we are here but 1 hour, 2 hour. After worship finish, we have a small fellowship and we scatter again. Various place. Our company, our school, our place. Some believers even far. Some believers come from very far, other city. When we scatter, when we became scattering church, what we should do? When we gather together, we worship, we pray, we have a fellowship, we study Bible. But after church is scattered, and church scattered to various places, our house, our family, our school, our working place, our city, what we should do? We should do according to the words of God. When Jerusalem church believers, because of persecution, when they scatter to Phoenicia, and Antioch and Cyprus, today what Jehovah say, they spread gospel. Amen? Why? Because Jerusalem, in Jerusalem there was a gospel. In Jerusalem people know Jesus Christ died for sin and he was resurrected 3 days after his death. Anyone who believed, anyone who hear this and believe in Jesus Christ, sin can be forgiven, can be saved. People in Jerusalem, they already knew. Because there was, you know, powerful Holy Spirit working. So gospel was being spread explosively. But our God never won. People in, only people in Jerusalem know that. Our God won every people, every national people, every ethnic people, every people in every place. Our God want them to know good news of Jesus Christ. Amen? That's why this also God's intention. There's a persecution and believers scatter. Without persecution, maybe believers maybe continue staying only Jerusalem. And outside Jerusalem, people still don't know Jesus Christ. It's not what our God wants. Amen?
Amen.
That's why Agape Church also, whenever we have a chance, we try to go other place, our niche, to the place where many internet people stay. But there's no church, no worship. That's why they don't know Jesus Christ. So whatever, whenever we have a chance, we try to go other place, our niche. Why? To show the gospel. Amen?
Amen.
Because it's what Bible say. It's what Bible say. The believers, Jerusalem church, when they scattered, not only they go other place and worship, there they introduce Jesus Christ. There they witness about Jesus Christ. There they spread the good news of Jesus Christ. We are all sinners, so we should go to hell. But Jesus Christ, the God of the whole universe, the creator of the whole universe, he loves us. He died on the cross for our sin. So he made the perfect solution for our sin. And he is God. That's why he didn't finish with only death on the cross. 3 days after his death, he overcame death, power of death. He overcame power of sin. And he gloriously was resurrected. Through which he made the perfect solution for our sin. Now, anyone who hear this, anyone who believe in Jesus Christ, that he died for our sin and resurrected, once sin can be forgiven. And the person never go to hell but go to eternal kingdom of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
We also should spread this good news of Jesus Christ when we are scattered. Amen.
Amen.
Once again, after 2 hour, 1 hour, when worship finish, we scatter, all scatter. 안정리, you know, 평택, or other city. There, what we should do? There, what we should do during the week? Of course, we working, we do our job. But not only that thing. We are scattering church. As a scattering church, we have a mission. When we are scattered, our mission is witnessing our Lord Jesus Christ. Our mission is spreading good news of Jesus Christ to the people who don't know that. If you believe, let's say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. So anyway, you know, the believers of the Jerusalem church, when there is a persecution, that's why they know able to be scattered. When they are scattered, they went to, you know, Phoenicia and Cyprus, Antioch, maybe more place. There, they spread the gospel. We should be same. We should be same. Every Sunday, we are gathering church. But Monday through Saturday, we are scattering church. When we are scattered in our own place, we are missionary. If you believe, let's say amen.
Amen.
We are missionary. We are missionary. We are missionary for our family. We are missionary in our working place. We are the missionary in our to our neighbors. We should live as a missionary until we gather together to the church Sunday. Amen. Okay. Some believers go to Antioch. Today we are not say about Antioch Church because in Antioch really a wonderful church being organized. It can be really good exemplary church for all churches today. That's why we are study together about Antioch Church, and after we know about this church, and we try to imitate. We also try to be like this Antioch Church. So first, let's see what the city Antioch was. Okay, Antioch in Syria. Today, Antioch, this city is in Syria today and at the time. This city was originated from the name of Antiochus Dynasty. So what is Antiochus Dynasty? It's one of the four divided kingdom of Greek Empire. After Alexander the Great died, you know, Greek Empire divided into four kingdoms. Four kingdoms. One of the kingdom is Antiochus Dynasty. Yeah. So the city Antioch, you know, come from this dynasty, Antiochus. Yeah. And this city was the most famous one among the 16 Antioch cities that Seleucus Nicator first established around 3000 BC. Antioch in Syria was the most prosperous city next to Rome and Alexandria in the time of Roman Empire. Yeah. So this city is really a great city. It's a third city in Roman whole Roman Empire. It had around 500,000 population at the time, and the capital city of Syria. And it was estimated as Antakya in today's Turkey. In today's Turkey, there's a city, Antakya. This Antioch estimated as this city today, Turkey, Antakya. This city is closely related with the growth and the mission of early Christianity. Nicholas, one of the seven deacons in early church, was from Antioch, Acts 6:5. When some Christians who escaped from persecution against Jerusalem church and came to Antioch, preached the gospel to the people in Antioch, many of them accepted Jesus Christ as their only Savior and became Christian. Yeah. Okay, this is Antioch Church. So anyway, the believers of Jerusalem Church, when they are scattered because of persecution, they came to Antioch and they organized a church. Amen. So let's see what this church was like. Yeah. And why we should imitate this church. Yeah. How much good this church was. Let's see together. Okay. First, this church, Antioch church, was Gentile church. You know, Jerusalem church, mostly congregation Jewish people. Jewish people. Yeah? So it's like a Jewish church. But the Gentile church, mixed. There's Jewish people also, but also many, many Gentile people. It's like an international church. It's a multinational and a multi-ethnic church, like Agape International Church. Agape International Church is not only one nation, Korean or the Pakistan or Philippine. We are composed of many different nations. And also believers also had a different social status. Some are like, nobles, Roman citizen. Some are like a slave. Huh? Anyway, no matter what their status was, when they come to church in Jesus Christ, they are all brothers and sisters. Amen? Amen. We are all brothers and sisters in Christ. No matter what social status we had outside, it doesn't really matter. Real matter is we are one family in our Lord Jesus Christ. We have a new spiritual status. Amen? Amen. Anyway, this church, inside, they are different. Social status and background and the nationality different, ethnic different, skin color different. There's white, yellow, and also black. Very different. But this church was united strongly each other as one, without division, split, and conflict. It's an amazing thing. Amen? Amen. How? How? If church is filled with the Holy Spirit, able to be like this. Amen? Amen? Holy Spirit, help us to be united strongly as one, even though we are very different. Our nationality, our social status, background, language, even different, if church is filled with the Holy Spirit, because of the power of the Holy Spirit, church can be united as one. If you believe, let's say amen.
Amen.
Amen. So this church was the church filled with the Holy Spirit and also filled with agape love, God's love. Corinthian church, is full of spiritual gift, but lack of spiritual, the fruit, especially agape love. That's why the church was the church being divided, splitted, conflict each other. Inside many different parties, groups. But this church, Antioch church, very various. But in Holy Spirit, they are united together as one. Amen. Agape International Church also, we have a really big variety, but we continue to pray. We seek for being filled with the Holy Spirit. So by the help of the Holy Spirit, let's pray this church, Agape International Church, can be very strongly united church. And the church can be filled with our God's love, agape love. So every believers, regardless of our difference, we love each other. We united together. We serve together. We cooperate together. We work together for precious work of God. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah, so chapter 13, verse 1 say, now in the church at Antioch, there were prophets and the teachers, Barnabas, Simeon called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaim, who had been brought up with Herod the Tetrarch. Manaim, he the one who was grown together with Herod the Tetrarch, the king over the Galilee area. It means he was he was from palace, yeah, but when he come to the Antioch church, regardless of his status, you know, he became one with other believers who have a low special the social status. Regardless of that, every believers in Antioch church, they strongly united. Amen. And also, Antioch church, there are good workers of God in the church. There are good workers of God in the church. Okay, Acts chapter 13, verse 1 to 3, Acts chapter 13, to the words of God, verse 1 and 2 say, now in the church at Antioch, there were prophets and teachers. Prophets and teachers. There are workers. Amen. Amen. Barnabas, Simeon, called the Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, who had been brought up with Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. These are list of workers in the church, prophets and teachers. And especially Barnabas and Saul, they were sent to Gentile nation as a missionary. This church, there are good workers of God. Brother Peppers, you know, Jesus Christ said, the harvest is plentiful, but workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. Yeah. Jesus Christ needed workers. Amen. When Jesus Christ, he did public ministry, many people followed Jesus Christ. Numerous people followed Jesus Christ. But they are all like, you know, the multitude. They follow Jesus Christ to get some help or for their needs. But among them, there is no, you know, workers. They just follow Jesus Christ for their own some like, you know, the benefits or profits for their needs. They are called multitude. But what really Jesus Christ needs is disciples, those who try to do same like Jesus Christ, try to do same work that Jesus Christ did. Amen? What Jesus Christ needs is workers. Church also, of course, every believer is precious. I know. Jesus Christ know. Jesus Christ love everybody. Jesus Christ know. Jesus Christ love everybody. Every believer is very precious, very lovable. But you know, for God's kingdom, kingdom's expansion, you know, church need workers. Church need workers. And also, Jesus Christ say, go and make disciples of all nation, and baptize them in the name of God, Father, Son, Jesus Christ, and teach them to obey whatever I have commanded you. Jesus Christ definitely command, make disciples, make believers into disciples. Amen. So, church need workers. Anyway, this church, there are good workers. Yeah. Okay. Barnabas, you know, he was a good man, full of Holy Spirit and faith. And he was the man increase the believers to remain truth to the law with all their heart. And later, he was sent with Paul as a missionary to Gentile nation. And also Simeon, he was a prophet, a black convert from Cyrene to the Libya. Maybe some people say he may be the Simon who burdened the cross to the hill of Golgotha instead of Jesus Christ. Not sure, but some people like that. Anyway, there is a good worker, Simeon, the prophet, in the church of Antioch. And Lucius, he's a prophet, one of the Christians who went to Antioch because of persecution in Jerusalem and spread the gospel to Greek. And also Manaem, yeah. He's a teacher. He's the teacher, teaching Bible. Great, and also a great evangelist. He had been brought up in the palace together with Herod, Antipas, the tetrarch who ruled Galilee and Varea area from BC 42 AD 39. He's the one who killed John the Baptist and did the trial on Jesus Christ. Same people grown up together, but one person became, you know, great man of God, teacher, and a great evangelist. But another person, Herod Antipas, became great, really big enemy against Jesus Christ. He's the one who killed John the Baptist. He the one did the trial on Jesus Christ. And also Saul, he's Paul. He's a great missionary to Gentile people who spread the gospel to Asia Minor and Europe and established many churches in those areas. Anyway, this church has these wonderful God's workers. Amen. So we also pray. We also need to pray. Agape Internet Church also can have many good workers who are willing to devote themselves to do work of God for extend God's kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Of course, all believers precious. Our God loves all believers. But for God's kingdom's sake, God's kingdom's sake, we need worker. Amen. Without worker, how can God's kingdom can be extended? How gospel can be spread? How can soul can be, you know, saved? We need worker. This church have workers, good workers. We should pray Agape Internet Church also can have many good devoted workers for our God. Amen. And also, this church did what our God was pleased. So God's hand was with them. Today, Bible portion 11, 22, 21 say, some of them, however, men from Cyprus and Cyrene went to Antioch and began to speak to Greeks also, telling them the good news about the Lord Jesus. The Lord's hand was with them. And a great number of people believed and turned to the Lord. What the Lord's hand stands for? What does Lord's hand stand for? Actually, Lord's hand stands for God's power, God's you know, the strength, God's you know, miracle, God's almighty. God's hand stands for all those things. Amen. God's power, God's miracle, God's working were on this church, Antioch Church. Why? Because this church was a church doing what our Lord Jesus Christ was pleased, what our Lord Jesus Christ is happy. This church did. That's why God's hand was upon this church. God's power, God's the working, God's miracle was were on this church. Amen.
Amen.
So what this church did? What the thing that our Lord Jesus Christ pleased? This church did. This church spread the gospel to the Gentile people. Amen?
Amen.
Not only Jewish people. If we see 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3, 3, 4, here say, our God, the God, our Savior, who wants all people to be saved and come to the knowledge of truth. Amen?
Amen.
It's a God's desire. It's God's, you know, biggest, you know, wish. What our God is most concerned is not material or things. What our God concerned the most is soul. Soul. Our God concerned own soul so much. Our God never want soul go to hell because of sin, but our God want soul, to believe in Jesus Christ and sin forgiven, finally go to heaven. It's a God's biggest, you know, wish and desire. Amen? This church Antioch Church did that. They spread the gospel to the Gentile people who don't know Jesus Christ, who worship idols. That's why our guys are pleased with that, are happy with that. So today, Wojak said, God's hand was with his church. Do you want God's hand? Do you want God's hand is with Agape Internal Church?
Amen.
Then what should we do? What we should do? We should do like Antioch Church. Amen?
Amen.
We also actively share the gospel to the people who don't know Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Here say some of them, however, men from Cyprus and Cyrene went to Antioch and began to speak to Greeks also, telling them the good news about the Lord Jesus. They telling about good news of Jesus to Greeks, Gentile, and the Lord's hand was with them. The Lord's hand was with them. Beloved believers, if we do the things that our Lord Jesus Christ pleased, our God's hand is with us. Amen? Our God's power, our God's miracle, our God's amazing thing is with us. If we do the things that our Lord Jesus Christ pleased. And what is the thing that our Lord Jesus Christ pleased? Spreading gospel to the people who don't know that. According to this word of God. If you believe, let's say amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's why Agape Internal Church or Agape River, let's be active in spreading gospel to the people who don't know Jesus Christ actively. Amen.
Amen.
Especially many internal people who are from Islam nation, Hindu nation, Buddhism nation, communist nation, they are all ignorant of gospel, all ignorant of goodness of Jesus Christ. Let's actively spread the gospel to them. Amen. Then our Lord Jesus Christ surely will be pleased with us, and our God's hand will be with us. Once again, if you believe, let's say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And also this church, Antioch Church, had a good reputation to outside. This church was a church that has a good reputation to outside. Some church, had a bad reputation. Eh? That church is fighting. Eh? The church, some immoral thing happened. Eh? Blah, 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 blah. Some church had a, bad reputation. So make our God shameful to the people, outside people. But this church was a church had a good reputation to outside. Here say news of this reached the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. Good reputation about Antioch church even known to Jerusalem church. Oh, Antioch church, God's hand was with them. Church being revived greatly. They are very active spreading gospel to the Gentile people. God was very pleased with the church. Good reputation. Good news about this church being spread to even church in Jerusalem. Jerusalem church. That's why this church sent Barnabas to more encourage Antioch church. To help more Barnabas, the Antioch church. Let's pray Agape Internal Church also can have a good reputation to outside people. Amen?
Amen.
All Agape Church, all believers, they are holy. They love each other. They are very kind. They are very active in serving non-believers. They are very devoted in spreading gospel. Agape Internal Church is a wonderful church. Let's pray this church can have this good reputation to outside people so that our God can be glorified. Amen.
Amen.
And also, this church was very active in teaching words of God to believers to make them be true Jesus Christ disciples and to be and be become true Christ-like believers, Christian. Okay, here say, so for a whole year, Barnabas and Saul met with the church and taught great number of people in the church, Antioch church. So these believers became the disciples. And these disciples were called Christian as a first at Antioch. Brother Alperbo, today, those who believe in Jesus Christ, they are called Christian, right? So what does mean Christian? We know Christ-like, Christ-like. It's a Christian, Christ. They are like a Jesus Christ. They are like a Jesus Christ. That's the meaning of Christian. Yeah? So where this calling started? Started from this church, Antioch church. That's why this church is really, you know, special. Today, all people who believe in Jesus Christ, they are called Christian. Where that calling started? That calling started this church, Antioch church. Why they are called Christian? Because they are like, they are really like Jesus Christ. Christian means Christ-like. Christ-like. They are holy. They are kind. They are, you know, gentle and good character. They are very, you know, purified. And also they are really full of love. Even love enemy. They are active, spreading gospel. They are like Jesus Christ. That's why people call them, wow, Christian, Christ-like. Amen? How this church, Antioch church, believer, they can be Christ-like, Christian. This was what I say. There was, you know, very active teaching words of God. Amen? You know, without teaching words of God, believers can be like this. Yeah? But, you know, some church problem is believers don't like learning words of God. There's a Bible studying. Always. But problem is believers not come. Problem is believers not come, not interested. Yeah? Never interested. Learning Bible, no, never interested. But beloved our people, without studying Bible, we cannot be like Jesus Christ. Words of God is not ink on the paper. It's a living, active, it's a working in us. It's changing, transforming our soul and spirit, our life. Words of God is a living, powerful words of God. Amen? Yeah. If we read, meditate, studying, it changes our life. That's why we should love words of God. We should love learning words of God. We love sharing words of God. Read words of God. Maintain words of God. Without that, even we 10-year fast, same like, you know, baby Christian, infant Christian, no maturity, immature, selfish, never willing to devote, not holy. The church, very active in teaching words of God. And many believers actively join. And finally, because of active teaching and really, love to learn words of God, this church full of disciples. And they are called Christian, Christ-like believers. Agape church should be same. Not only Agape, every church should be same. Amen? Amen? Church should be very active in teaching words of God. Some people misunderstood church as the place of solving problem. Problem, come to church, being solved, slow, coming, and problem again come. Again solved, slow. When it come, not come. If good come, bad come, not come. Again problem come. Some people misunderstand church is like this. But church never be like that. Amen? Amen. Church is a place where we worship our God in spirit and truth. Amen? Church is the place we pray to our God. And in church the place we learn words of God. And we live according to the words of God. Amen?
Amen.
This church give a very good example to all church today. Paul and Barnabas 1 year actively teach to the believers. And believers also, you know, positively respond to their teaching. Here's a great number of believers come to learn words of God. So, you know, when believers love to learn words of God, you know, through learning words of God, they are transformed, they are changed, they are, you know, equipped, armored with words of God, they grow spiritually, they became mature, they became Jesus disciple, they are called Christ-like believers. Christian? Christian? Amen?
Amen.
So, Agape Internet Church also, beloved Agape Brothers, we have a Bible study. Every national Bible study, Saturday, cell group leader Bible study, you know, Chuseok, Lunar Year, we provide various Bible study program. Important thing is, Agape Holy Believers, we should love to learn words of God. Amen. We should thirsty and hunger for words of God, like a deer thirsty for the water. Without that, church, no growth. You know, believers, no transformation, no change. Believers, not become like a Christ, not true Christian. Amen.
Amen.
So let's pray. Agape Church continue to be very active in sharing words of God. Let's pray Agape Holy Brother love really words of God. Actively join, you know, the Bible studying and the meeting, sharing, learning, you know, teaching words of God.
Amen.
If you agree, let's say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Actually, why Antioch Church did like that? Because Jesus command, Matthew 28, 18 through 20, we know very well. Many times we are repeated, remind, emphasize again. Jesus command like this. That's why Antioch Church did like that. And every church today also same. We should do like that. Here say, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make a disciple of all nations. Make a disciple. Not just church believer. Make a disciple. Jesus Christ's commandment is make a disciple. What is disciple? The people, the believers who like Jesus Christ, the believers who do the thing that Jesus Christ did, that's your disciples. Yeah. Baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you is the way making disciples. Teaching them to obey. How much teaching? As much as they obey, not only just learning, occupying, accumulating and filing the knowledge, as much as they obey to the thing they learn, that much teach is the way making disciples. According to this Jesus Christ Great Commission, you know, Antioch Church very active in teaching, and also believers positively respond to that, teaching. They actively join. That's why believers, you know, change, transform into good Christian, good believers, Christ-like believers. We also pray Agape Internet Church became like this. Amen?
Amen.
Agape Church continually provide good Bible studying, Bible studying meetings, and not only providing believers actively respond positively. Every the Bible study meeting, actively join. Each national Bible study meeting, actively join. You know, last time, through around 2 months, we had a cell group meeting training. So we finished one book. So some national leaders, they trained, they studying together. So they're going to organize the cell group so that the leaders will teach the book they study to other believers. When the kind of a cell group is being made, please actively join. Actively try to learn words of God. Try to study the Bible. Without that, we cannot expect the transformation and change of ourselves. Without that, we cannot expect to grow our spirituality into maturity. Amen. Okay, and this church, it practiced God's love through helping the needy people. During this time, some prophet came down from Jerusalem to Antioch. One of them, named Agabus, his prophet, stood up and through the Spirit predicted that severe famine would spread over the entire Roman world. This happened during the reign of Claudius. The disciples, as each one was able, decided to provide help for the brothers and sisters living in Judea. This they did, sending their gift to the elders by Barnabas and Saul. Okay. The prophet Agabus, he prophesied that there gonna be a severe famine. Really happened when? In the time of Claudius. It's a Roman emperor. He reigned Roman Empire AD 41 to 54. Especially AD 45, there was a great famine in Palestine. Yeah, Palestine. At the time, the believers in Jerusalem, they were very needy because of severe famine. So Antioch Church, what they did? They collected material and they sent the material to Jerusalem Church to help them, the needy believers there. Which church started first? Jerusalem Church started first. And later, Antioch Church started later. Then actually, Jerusalem Church should help Antioch Church. But Antioch Church helped Jerusalem Church. That much this church was a very mature church. Yeah? Really, you know, wonderful church, really good church. Amen? Even started later, when the Jerusalem Church, they started first, earlier, when they are needy, they are not ignored, they are not rugable. They tried to do something. They collected the material and they send the material to the church to help needy believers in Jerusalem Church. So this church is the church practice God's love. They practice the words of God they learn. Words of God only teach to love others, not verbally, through our action. If somebody needy, we should help. They not only know the words of God, they practiced. They did. It's the Antioch Church. Amen? James 2, 14 through 17 say, what good is it, my brothers and sisters, if someone claims to have a faith but have no deeds? Can such a faith save them? Suppose a brother or sister is without clothes and daily food. If one of you say to them, go in peace, keep warm and well fed, but does nothing about their physical needs, what good is it? In the same way, faith by itself, if it is not accompanied by action, is dead. Amen. According to this word of God, we believe in Jesus Christ. We say we believe in Jesus, but if we don't do action, it's like a dead faith. It's not real faith, true faith. Amen. The Antioch Church is a church that have a true faith because they practiced what they believe. They did what they know, the words of God. Amen. Agape Church also, not only the church that know words of God, but the church that practice what we know. Amen. And also this church, they listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit and obey to the voice of the Holy Spirit. Yeah, this church communicate with the Holy Spirit. They very sensitive to voice of Holy Spirit. They listen to Holy Spirit. When they listen to Holy Spirit, they obey to the voice of Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. While they were worshiping the Lord, and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, below the purpose, Holy Spirit speak to us. Revelation chapter 2, verse 7, 11, 17, 29, chapter 3, 6, 13, 22, continue to say. Same words continue to say, through seven times. Whoever has ear, let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. Holy Spirit speak to the church. Holy Spirit to speak to the believers. But problem is, sometimes church don't listen to the voice. Believers don't listen to the voice. Holy Spirit speak to us. We should be able to listen what Holy Spirit try to say to us. Amen? We should repent our sin. We try to keep purified. And we should ardently seek for, you know, through prayer to listen to Holy Spirit. Amen? Amen. If we ardently seek for that, we can listen. He'll say, Jeremiah 33:3, he'll say, call to me, and I will answer to you, and tell you, great and unsearchable thing you do not know. If you seek, I'm going to tell. Our God say, promise. Amen? So if we want to listen to the voice of Holy Spirit, we can listen. Why we cannot listen? Because actually we don't too much, you know, desire. We don't care. We don't try to listen. Our God promise, call to me, I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable thing you do not know. If we ardently seek, our God promise, I'm gonna talk to you. I'm gonna say to you. We are able to listen to the voice of Holy Spirit. If we believe, let's say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Proverbs 8:17. I love those who love me, and those who seek me find me. If we seek ardently Holy Spirit, we can hear the voice of Holy Spirit. We can experience our Holy Spirit. If I ardently seek, amen? Antioch Church was that kind of church. This is a church, you know, hear voice of Holy Spirit. Here say, while they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them. So after they had fasted and prayed, they placed their hands on them and sent them off. So what Holy Spirit said to the Antioch church? Holy Spirit say, set apart, separate, Paul and Barnabas to send them as a missionary to Gentile nation. They listen to this voice of Holy Spirit, and after that, they pray and more checking, and finally they confirm it's a voice of God, voice of Holy Spirit, just sure. And when they are confirmed, you know, when they are sure, they, you know, they ordained Barnabas and Paul as a missionary and sent them to Gentile place as a missionary. And this is very significant. This is very significant. Why? This is the first time in church history that some specific people were sent as a missionary to Gentile nation. It's the first time. So Antioch church was a church that sending missionary to Gentile nation as a first in church history. That's why this church is very, you know, special. This church was a church that was called as a Christian as a first. This church was a church that sent the missionary to Gentile nation as a first. That's why Antioch church is very special. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. So this church hear the voice of Holy Spirit and obey to Holy Spirit and finally send Paul and Barnabas as a missionary to Gentile nation. Amen?
Amen.
We also ardently seek for hearing voice of Holy Spirit. Amen?
Amen.
God promised we ardently seek, we are able to hear. Amen?
Amen?
Once again, let's remember this word of God. It's a promise. It's a God's promise. Okay, let's read together. Here say, call to me, and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. Amen? So they not only listen to the voice of Holy Spirit, they obey to the voice of Holy Spirit and send Paul and Barnabas as a missionary to Gentile nation, Asia Minor, today Turkey area, and they even go to Europe, spreading gospel, establish many churches. Uh, Philadelphia people, not only Antioch Church. And the Antioch Church, why like this? Because the Holy Spirit say like this, and also already Jesus Christ say, go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned. Already Jesus Christ command, go into the world and preach the gospel, and to all creation. And Acts 1:8, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in whole Judea and Samaria, and to the end of the earth. Jesus already command. And our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Trinity, they are three, but they are one. Amen. What Jesus God say? Holy Spirit say, same. What God say? Holy Spirit say, same. What God say? Jesus God say, same. Amen. That's why what Jesus Christ say, Holy Spirit say again, send missionary for God's kingdom's sake, for God's kingdom to be extended to the end of the earth. It's God's biggest desire. Amen. That's why Agape Internet Church also should send the missionary first here in Korea. You know, there are many places where many internet people staying here in Korea now. Wherever we go, there are many internet people. We already experience through circuit evangelism. Once a month, we visit some city. You know, there are many the internet people wherever go, but no church in worship. Many Korean churches, but no internet church. Even there is, but just one, two. You know, never enough. So we pray. We continue to pray. We reach there. Of course, our God do everything, but we pray. Those area, church can be established, workers are sent there, and really gospel being spread those areas. So wherever internet people, they are staying, there they are able to hear the gospel, we pray. And also Agape River, we are here in Korea now, but one day, you know, we don't know what happened. Because of some situation, we may go back our nation. Already, there are many ex-Agape River. They are scattered whole world now. We pray when Agape River leave away from Korea to other nation, go as a missionary. Amen?
Amen.
So really this church, like Antioch Church, this church also can send precious missionary to many, many places where people don't know Jesus Christ and where people don't believe in Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, today, Philadelphia verse, we have seen Antioch Church because we want Agape Internet Church to become really good God's church, the church that our Lord Jesus Christ pleased. So we need to have some example, good example, exemplary church. We believe Antioch Church become good exemplary church to us. That's why we have a study. So, not only we study, not only we know about the church, let's try to imitate this church. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. Let's try to be a church like this. We continue to pray. Yeah. Agape Internet Church, like Antioch Church, can be united strongly, even we are so various each other. And also, we pray Agape Internet Church, there can be many good workers who devote themselves to the work of God. And also, we pray, Agape Internet Church do what our God is pleased, spreading gospel actively to the non-believers. And also, this church may have a good reputation to other side. And also, Agape Internet Church, in our church, there can be very active, sharing the words of God, and believers actively join. So all believers can be true Jesus Christ disciples, not just church believer, but become Jesus Christ disciples. All believers can be true Christian, true Christ-like believers, Christian. And also, let's pray Agape Internet Church practice God's love. This church can practice what we learn through words of God. And also, we pray ardently seeking so we can listen to the voice of Holy Spirit. Not only listen to the voice of Holy Spirit, we can obey to voice of Holy Spirit. And also, we pray Agape Central Church can be the church that send many missionaries to many places all over the world. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, let's pray. Yeah.